Some data loss cases, for example data loss from NAS, require that you eject hard drives from the device and connect them to an auxiliary computer for recovery. If you have basic technical skills, you will easily solve this task. This guide will give you some tips as for the sequence for connecting the hard drives to internal slots of the auxiliary computer. Before we start, I would like to give you some safety guidelines. Please read them carefully. Before you connect disks to the computer, I advise you to check what disks are displayed in the disk manager at the moment. This will allow you to identify the connected disks in the future without any difficulties. To do this, in Windows 7, go to Start menu, invoke Context menu of the computer, select Manage and Run Disks Manager. Now you can see the disks connected to your computer. In Windows 8, do the following. Press Windows plus X keyboard shortcut, select Disk Management in the menu. To power the computer off, find a switcher on the rear panel of the system block and press it. Some power supply units don't have such a switcher. In this case, just unplug the system block. Now that the computer is unplugged, you can open it. To do this, remove the screws on the rear panel that hold the side panel. Just like this, the upper and the lower. Now you can easily remove the side panel. And now you have access to the contents of the system block. In this guide, we show an easy procedure of connecting SATA disks. This includes connecting the disk to two cables, a power cable and a SATA data cable. First, connect the SATA cable to appropriate slots on the motherboard. Find a free power cable connected to a power supply unit in your system block. If your system block doesn't have a power cable with the SATA slot, you should use an adapter. If you don't have enough power cables, you can use a splitter. Connect SATA cable to the hard drive. Now the disk is connected. If you recover data from NAS, you should connect all the working disks. Notice that you will need to mark all the disks. That will make read assembly and further NAS recovery much easier for you. If you lack SATA slots, use a special USB to SATA adapter. After you have connected all necessary disks, you can power and turn the computer on. Check in the disk manager if you have connected all disks correctly. If you have done everything right, you can find the disks in the list of devices. Otherwise, shut down the computer, plug it off, and check all the contacts. Now you can proceed to data recovery.